Hello friends, I will continue with the topic partnership final accounts. Today I am going to discuss the guidelines for solving the problem. These guidelines I am going to discuss in two parts. First, I will discuss the steps for solving the problem, and second, I am going to give you the general instructions which are necessary for solving the problem. Now we see the first one. Steps for solving problem on final account. Whenever you are solving the problem, you have to follow these steps. If you are following these steps, it will be convenient to you to tally the problem. If you are not comfortable with these steps, you can also use your own steps. There is no rule that you have to follow these steps. These steps are only for convenience. Let me explain the first step. Before solving the problem, you will be preparing a format, which is known as prepare the format. I have explained in my previous lecture, while explaining the formats, there I explained one blank format. You can refer to that blank format. So you should be ready with a blank format before solving the problem. In blank format, what you are writing? First, at the top, you will be writing the name of the firm. Then, you will be writing the headings, trading account for the year ended so and so, profit and loss account for the year so and so, then partners capital account, A and B, whatever is the case. And in balance sheet, you will be writing balance sheet as on. After preparing the format, now you will see the sum. You refer to the sum. So, marking of trial balance. What you will do? You will read each and every item of trial balance, and in your mind you will decide which item goes where. Or you can do the marking with the help of pencil, whether the item belongs to trading account debit side, credit side, profit and loss debit side, profit and loss credit side, asset side, liability side. Like this you can do the marking. In addition to this, what is important is read the adjustments. And there are two types of adjustments. Some are independent. Say for example, closing stock has two effects. Trading account credit side and balance sheet asset side is not affecting any existing item. But if suppose there is an outstanding salary, then outstanding salary, one effect is add to salaries, and second effect is on the liability side. So now salaries in the trial balance, you have to do some marking. What marking you will be doing? You will do a tick mark against that particular item, or you will put some dot against that item, or you will be doing some other, you will be using some other signs, whichever is suitable to you. What will happen when you will be marking the trial balance items? Whenever you will start posting, you will remember that this particular item you are supposed to write into the inner column, and that is why marking is essential. Otherwise, what will happen? You will write to the outer column and you will be writing the next item, and afterwards you will come to know that there is an adjustment. So there will be a spacing problem. So to remove all these problems, marking is necessary. After that, we will go to the trial balance. Trial balance, each and every item, we will start from the debit side. Each and every item on trial balance is transferred either in the trading account, profit and loss account, capital account, or in the balance sheet. How many times? Once only. And all the items of credit side also will be transferring. How many times? Once only. If suppose we are given J format of trial balance, then sometimes debit is coming, sometimes credit is coming. So accordingly you can transfer debit item on the debit side and credit item on the credit side. What is the J form? This is the J form, like this. So if suppose one item is here on the debit side, another is on the credit side, again third is on the credit side, fourth is on the debit side. So you have to take up each and every item right from the beginning. Then that time you will not see which is debit and which is credit. So starting from beginning, and you will be transferring till the end. Okay, that's the procedure that you will be following. After completing the trial balance, transfer of adjustments. Now you will move to the adjustments. And for each and every adjustment, you will do two effects. So whether they are to be added or they are to be subtracted. So whatever may be the case, you will transfer each and every adjustments. Now when transferring the adjustments, again you have to remember, sometimes there are some adjustments which may be, suppose adjustment number 4 is there. Adjustment number 4 is bad debts and adjustment number 6 is unrecorded sales. Now adjustment number 6 unrecorded sales you have to do first, because in the debtors unrecorded sales is shown first and bad debt is shown afterwards. So you have to take care that which adjustments you have to take up first and which adjustments you have to take up afterwards. Okay, so once these adjustments are transferred, now you will move to close the trading account. So whatever the inner column is there comes to the outer column. Close the trading account. If the difference is gross profit, write on the debit side. If the difference is gross loss, it will appear on the credit side. And it is transferred to the profit and loss account. Then profit and loss account, again, all inner column will be casted to outer column. Profit and loss account is closed. In profit and loss account, you may get net profit or net loss. Whatever may be the case, you will be distributing these partners, this net profit or net loss to the partners in their profit sharing ratio. Okay, and you will close the profit and loss account. Then you will close capital or current account. So whatever are the balances, you will close the capital account. So the capital account will show some balance, either debit or credit, and that balance you are going to transfer to the balance sheet. So close partner's capital or current account, and the balances will be written on the balance sheet, written on the liability side or on the asset side, as the case may be. And at last, all the inner column will be casted to the outer column, and the balance sheet, liability side and asset side, both will tally. So these are the steps that you have to follow for solving the problem. If you are following these steps, then it will be easy for you to complete the sum and you will be able to tally the sum. Okay. Now we will see the general instructions for solving the problem. What are the general instructions? There are certain items which are confusing in nature. So we are making it clear. Say for example, the first item is a trade expense. Now trade expense, you have to refer to the trial balance. If in a trial balance, trade expense is the only item which is given, okay, then that trade expense is transferred profit and loss on the profit and loss debit side. Now but suppose, along with the trade expense, there is a general expense or miscellaneous expense or sundry expense, then the trade expense is not transferred to profit and loss account, but trade expense is transferred to trading account debit side. And all the general expense, miscellaneous or sundry expense, they are transferred to profit and loss account debit side. मैं आपको और एक बार बताता हूँ कि यदि trial balance के अंदर trade balance अकेला है, अकेला का मतलब होता है trade expense है और general expense, miscellaneous expense, sundry expense, ऐसा कोई item नहीं है, तो क्या समझेगा? Trade expense is an item of profit and loss account, so you'll be transferring on the debit side of profit and loss account. मगर ट्रेड एक्सपेंस भी है और उसके साथ में जनरल एक्सपेंस है, या ट्रेड एक्सपेंस के साथ में मिसेलेनियस एक्सपेंस है, या ट्रेड एक्सपेंस के साथ में सन्ड्री एक्सपेंस है, ऐसे वक्त पे ट्रेड एक्सपेंस को प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट में ट्रांसफर नहीं करेंगे और हम ट्रांसफर करेंगे ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट में. और जो दूसरा आइटम हमको दिया है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल सन्ड्री एक्सपेंस दिया है, तो हम उसको लिखेंगे प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस डेबिट साइड पे. ओके, अब हम देखेंगे सेकंड हमारे पास एक आइटम है जिसका नाम है कैरेज, फिर कैरेज इनवर्ड, फिर कैरेज ऑन परचेजेस. ये तीनों का मतलब एक ही है. कैरेज मींस कैरेज चार्जेस पेड फॉर, इट इज अ ट्रांसपोर्ट चार्जेस पेड फॉर रोड ट्रांसपोर्ट फॉर कैरिंग द गुड्स फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अदर प्लेस. एंड विच गुड्स, वेन एवर वी आर बाइंग द गुड्स, that time whatever carriage is paid, that is known as a carriage inward. So carriage, carriage inward and carriage on purchase, where we are placing trading account डेबिट साइड, तो ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट के डेबिट साइड में ये होते हैं। इसके जैसे वैसे ही फ्रेट भी है, फ्रेट फ्रेट इनवर्ड एंड फ्रेट ऑन परचेज। फ्रेट मीन्स इट इज अगेन ट्रांसपोर्ट एक्सपेंस, बट इट इज अ वाटर ट्रांसफर एंड एयर ट्रांसपोर्ट। ओके, फ्रेट फ्रेट इनवर्ड एंड फ्रेट ऑन परचेज, दे आर ऑल्सो प्लेस ऑन द डेबिट साइड ऑफ ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट। एंड एट द सेम टाइम सपोज वी आर हैविंग कैरेज आउटवर्ड, कैरेज आउटवर्ड और कैरेज ऑन सेल्स। तो कैरेज आउटवर्ड एंड कैरेज ऑन सेल्स का मतलब है कैरेज पेड ऑन सेल ऑफ गुड्स। सो दिस इज नॉट रिलेटेड टू ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट, दिस इज रिलेटेड टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट। सो वेयर वी विल बी प्लेसिंग, वी विल बी प्लेसिंग ऑन द डेबिट साइड ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट कैरेज आउटवर्ड एंड कैरेज ऑन सेल्स, दैट इज प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस डेबिट साइड। ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी आइटम नंबर थ्री। आइटम नंबर थ्री इज रॉयल्टी ऑन, रॉयल्टी ऑन परचेज, रॉयल्टी ऑन प्रोडक्शन एंड रॉयल्टी ऑन सेल्स। Now royalty on purchase and royalty on production is a direct expense, so they are transferred to trading account on debit side, and royalty on sales is indirect expense, so transfer to profit and loss account debit side. That is the difference. Okay, now we'll see item number 4. Item number 4 is wages, wages and salaries, productive wages, unproductive wages, and at the same time are also right salaries, salaries and wages, वर्क मैनेजर सैलरी, वर्क मैनेजर्स मैनेजर्स सैलरीज, जो कभी आपका 7 आइटम्स है। वेजेस मीन्स डायरेक्ट एक्सपेंस ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट डेबिट, वेजेस एंड सैलरीज इट इज अ कंबाइंड हेडिंग, बट प्रपोर्शन ऑफ वेजेस इज मोर देन सैलरीज, सो इट इज कंबाइंड। सो वेजेस अपियर्स फर्स्ट, so again trading account debit side. Productive wages, it is clearly mentioned productive means related to factory, so productive wages again trading account debit side. Then unproductive wages, unproductive wages means indirect expense not related to factory, related to office, so profit and loss debit side. So unproductive wages, even though the word wages is there, but it will appear in the profit and loss account on debit side. Salaries, indirect expense, profit and loss debit side. Salaries and wages, again proportion of salaries more, so profit and loss debit side. Work manager salary, here the word salary is there, but again the word works manager, works manager is working in the factory, so it is a direct expense, so profit and loss account, sorry, trading account debit. So trading account debit, profit and loss account debit, profit and loss account debit. Here accordingly you can see, now once again ek bar fir main samjhaunga, wages trading account debit side mein aata hai, wages and salaries diya hai to trading account ke debit side mein aayega, productive wages diya hai to trading account debit side mein aayega, magar unproductive wages diya hai to profit and loss debit mein jayega. Waise hi salary diya hai to profit and loss debit mein jayega, सैलरीज एंड वेजेस दिया है तो भी प्रॉफिट लॉस डेबिट में जाएगा। वर्क मैनेजर सैलरी, इधर सैलरी वर्ड दिया है मगर वर्क्स, वर्क्स मींस फैक्ट्री, फैक्ट्री का मैनेजर है, तो वर्क मैनेजर सैलरी है तो ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट डेबिट में जाएगा। ओके, नाउ वी सी नंबर 5, interest on capital and interest on drawings. Interest on capital. Time basis. जो इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल होता है हम किसको देते हैं? पार्टनर्स को देते हैं. ट्रेडिंग सॉरी प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट के डेबिट साइड में लिखेंगे, पार्टनर्स कैपिटल करंट अकाउंट में क्रेडिट साइड में लिखेंगे. और प्रॉब्लम के अंदर यदि कुछ टाइम दिया है कि भाई कैपिटल कभी इंट्रोड्यूस किया तो हमको टाइम के हिसाब से इंटरेस्ट देना चाहिए. मगर प्रॉब्लम के अंदर ट्रायल बैलेंस और एडजस्टमेंट साइलेंट है, कुछ भी नहीं बोला है प्रॉब्लम के अंदर, तो इसका मतलब हमको एक साल के लिए इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल कैलकुलेट करना है. सो हाउ द इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल इज टू बी कैलकुलेटेड? इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल इज टू बी कैलकुलेटेड फॉर हाउ मेनी मंथ्स? 12 मंथ्स. एंड कौन से बैलेंस पे? ओपनिंग बैलेंस पे. इन केस ऑफ फिक्स्ड कैपिटल मेथड हमारे पास कैपिटल अकाउंट भी है और करंट अकाउंट भी है. इन केस ऑफ फ्लक्चुएटिंग कैपिटल मेथड हमारे पास सिर्फ कैपिटल अकाउंट है. तो फ्लक्चुएटिंग कैपिटल मेथड में जो भी ओपनिंग बैलेंस रहेगा उसके ऊपर हमको कैलकुलेट करना है इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल फॉर हाउ मेनी मंथ्स? 12 मंथ्स. इन केस ऑफ फिक्स्ड कैपिटल मेथड जो भी आपको कैपिटल अकाउंट दिया है उसका जो भी बैलेंस है ओपनिंग बैलेंस उसके ऊपर आपको कैलकुलेट करना है 12 मंथ्स के. और जो करंट का बैलेंस है उसको आपको इग्नोर करना है. करंट का नेगेटिव बैलेंस हो या पॉजिटिव बैलेंस हो आपको करंट अकाउंट का बैलेंस देखना ही नहीं. तो दिस इज द प्रोविजन फॉर इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल. नाउ नंबर 6 वी विल सी इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग्स. इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग्स अगेन टाइम बेसिस. यदि आपको प्रॉब्लम में टाइम दिया है तो टाइम के हिसाब से आपको कैलकुलेट करना है. बोला गया कि ये पार्टनर ये पर्टिकुलर डेट को गुड्स लेके गया, कैश लेके गया, तो हिसाब से आपको इंटरेस्ट कैलकुलेट करना है. मगर प्रॉब्लम में कोई टाइम नहीं दिया है तो हमको एवरेज बेसिस पे कैलकुलेट करना है. सो द इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग इज कैलकुलेटेड ऑन एन एवरेज बेसिस फॉर हाउ मेनी मंथ्स? 6 मंथ्स. एवरेज बेसिस पे आपको कैलकुलेट करना है 6 मंथ्स के लिए. दिस इज द प्रोविजन दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. एंड देन पोस्टिंग किधर करना है वो आपको पता ही है, प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट के क्रेडिट साइड में एंड कैपिटल और करंट अकाउंट के डेबिट साइड में. सो दीज आर द प्रोविजंस फॉर इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल एंड इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग्स. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस आइटम नंबर 7, कमीशन टू पार्टनर्स ऑन नेट प्रॉफिट और ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट. लेट मी टेक एन एग्जाम्पल. 10% कमीशन टू पार्टनर्स ऑन नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर चार्जिंग कमीशन. बिफोर चार्जिंग कमीशन. एंड लेट मी अज्यूम दैट नाउ लेट अस सी द फॉर्मूला फॉर दिस. फॉर्मूला इज रेट ऑफ कमीशन इंटू नेट प्रॉफिट अपॉन 100. सो लेट अस अज्यूम दैट द प्रॉफिट इज the rate is 10% and the profit is 11,000. So what will be the commission? Commission will be 1,100. 10% is 1,100. Now how we are going to show this in profit and loss account? Profit and loss account to commission to partner. What is the commission? 1,100. Okay. What will be the net profit? Net profit is 9,900 now. Because ये दोनों का total होके 100% होना चाहिए और ये जो है वो आपका 10% है और दूसरा वाला जो है आपका 90% है. इसको आप रिमेंबर रखिए, याद रखिए. ये कौन सा है? बिफोर वाला है. कौन सा? बिफोर वाला. अब मैं आपको दूसरा एग्जांपल लेता हूं. दूसरा एग्जाम्पल, 10% कमीशन टू पार्टनर ऑन नेट प्रॉफिट आफ्टर चार्जिंग सच कमीशन, आफ्टर चार्जिंग सच कमीशन. इन दिस केस व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला? फॉर्मूला इज रेट ऑफ कमीशन इनटू नेट प्रॉफिट, इनटू नेट प्रॉफिट अपॉन 100 प्लस रेट ऑफ कमीशन. सो से फॉर एग्जांपल, एज आई टोल्ड यू 11,000, सो 11 सॉरी रेट ऑफ कमीशन इज, रेट ऑफ कमीशन इज 10, नेट प्रॉफिट इज 11,000, 100 प्लस दैट इज 110. सो नाउ हियर द प्रॉफिट इज 1,000. सो व्हाट प्रॉफिट वी गॉट इन द प्रीवियस केस? 1,100. हियर वी गॉट प्रॉफिट 1,000. नाउ इन प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट हाउ आई एम प्लेसिंग? टू कमीशन टू पार्टनर is 1,000 and two net profit 10,000. So the total of both of these is 110%. 110%. This is 10% and this is 100%. So remember this formula for after. After charging such commission means this formula is applicable, and before charging commission means this particular formula is applicable. Total is 100, okay? 100 में से 10% उसको दे दिया तो 90% बचा. हमारे पास जो भी प्रॉफिट था उसमें से 10% दे दिया पार्टनर को तो 90% बचा फॉर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. सो 10 एंड 90 टोटल हो गए 100. इसके अंदर क्या है कि जो भी है वो टोटल है 100 प्लस 10, तो 10% उसको दे दिया 100% है, यानी कि ये 100% होना चाहिए. तो ये 100% है, ये 10% है, टोटल हो गया 110%. सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. समटाइम्स दिस मे बी आस, नॉर्मली इट इज नॉट आस. नॉर्मली व्हेन द वर्ड बिफोर एंड आफ्टर इज मिसिंग, जस्ट दे से दैट गिव 10% कमीशन टू द पार्टनर ऑन ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट और ऑन नेट प्रॉफिट, then you are going to apply this formula before वाला, okay? तो जब कोई before या afterward नहीं है तो आपको ये formula apply करना है, okay? Now let me give you the next instruction, which is the important trial balance items. These items are given in the trial balance, but we may face certain difficulties. So that is why let me clear it. I will take up with the first item, closing stock. Now normally closing stock is given in the adjustments and it is having two effects. It is never given in the trial balance, but sometimes if the trading account is prepared then it is given in the trial balance. So if the trading account is given, an item of gross profit or gross loss may be given in the trial balance, and at the same time closing stock is also given in the trial balance. So that time we have to do only one effect of the closing stock, and that effect is we are going to write closing stock on the asset side of the balance sheet. Now the second, outstanding expense, prepaid expense, income receivable and income received in advance. These are the four items which normally appear in the adjustments. We see the adjustment of outstanding expense, we see the adjustment of prepaid expense, we see the adjustment of incomes receivable, and we see the adjustments of incomes received in advance. But in this case, these items are not given by way of adjustments, but they are given by way of they are given in the trial balance. So say for example, outstanding expense. So outstanding expense normally we are adding, so that adding effect, that effect is already completed. Now only we are supposed to write outstanding expense on the liability side. Same way for prepaid expense, that particular expense is already subtracted and then only the trial balance is prepared. But now when we are given this item prepaid expense, it should be shown on the asset side. Same way income receivable, one effect is already completed and the second effect which we have to give on the asset side. Same way, income received in advance, one effect is already completed before preparing the trial balance. So now the second effect we will be giving on the liability side. So these are the second effects and these are given in the trial balance. So we have to do the posting once in the trial balance. Then same way we are given, sometimes the appreciation is normally given in the adjustment, but sometimes the depreciation is given in the trial balance. So in that case, they have already provided the depreciation, they have already subtracted from the asset, and we are given the net balance of the asset, and at the same time we are given the depreciation value. So depreciation, whatever is given, that will have only one effect on the debit side of profit and loss account. Now sometimes the trial balance, we could not tally the trial balance, and that is why after making number of efforts, if suppose trial balance does not tally, then the difference on the debit side is transferred to suspense account debit side, and the difference on the credit side may be transferred to suspense account credit side. So if suppose in the trial balance there is an item suspense account debit balance, then that we are going to transfer on the asset side of the balance sheet. Same way, if suppose suspense account credit balance is given, then we are supposed to transfer this balance on the liability side of the balance sheet. In the trial balance, sometimes we are given loss on sale of asset and profit on sale of asset. Both these items are related to sale of assets. So they are doing the calculation and we are given the pure figures for loss on sale of asset and profit on sale of asset. So if these figures are given, then the loss on sale of asset we are transferring to profit and loss debit side, and profit on sale of asset we are transferring profit and loss credit side. Now we are having four important items related to provident fund. Provident fund, this is the liability towards the employees. Whenever they will retire, the firm is supposed to make the payment to the employee in lump sum. So it's a liability. So provident fund is a liability, so we are placing on the liability side. Provident fund investment is asset. So whatever is the amount that belongs to the employee, that particular amount we have invested in the bank or some financial institute. So whenever the employee retires, that amount is taken out from that particular bank or from the institute and it is given to the employee. So on the liability side we have provident fund, and on the asset side we have provident fund investment. These both are related to the employees. Okay, so provident fund is a liability towards employees, and the same liability, same amount of liability we have already invested in some bank, so that is known as a provident fund investment. So take out the money and pay to the employees. Then provident fund contribution is when, how to make out this provident fund, that how this provident fund is accumulated. So there are two types of contribution. One, some amount we are deducting from the salary of the employee. Okay, so suppose the salary of the employee is 10,000, we'll deduct 1,000, and that 1,000 is provident fund contribution. At the same time, the employer is also contributing from his side as per the rules of the labor laws. Okay, so suppose the employer is contributing 2,000. So now the total amount is 3,000. This 3,000 is invested in the provident fund investment, and that 3,000 is added to the provident fund. So provident fund is a liability, provident fund is an investment, provident fund contribution is a contribution from the employer towards the provident fund. And interest on provident fund, now whatever amount is invested by us in the provident fund, that bank or that institute is going to give interest on that. So that interest is not our income, so we cannot show on the credit side of profit and loss account, but that particular income is added to the provident fund. So this is the liability and it is added to the provident fund in the balance sheet on the liability side. Okay, now I think I have given sufficient instructions so that you can manage to solve the problem. Okay, now I wish best of luck, that number of instructions and I have given full theory. So please solve the problems as you like.